Hi everyone, we're back with another video from Elearning Portal. Are you ready to supercharge your quizzes and keep your students laser focused on their learning journey? Well, today we're diving into the game-changing plugin that will revolutionize how you handle your quiz reattempts. Introducing Moodle's Hide Correctly Answered Questions on Reattempts. This powerful tool not only hides questions students have already nailed, but also auto-grades correct answers in future attempts. So say goodbye to repetitive reviewing and hello to efficient, targeted learning. Let's dive right in. First, we need to install the plugin. So go to the Moodle's plugin directory and type in Hide Correctly Answered Questions on Reattempts. You'll be taken straight to this page. Make sure that you download the correct version. So it's currently available for Moodle 4.4, so let's download that version. I'll go to my Moodle site and I'll go to Site Administration. I'll click on Plugins and then Install Plugins. I'll click on Choose File and then choose the file in my Downloads folder. I'll click on Open and then Upload and then install the plugin. I'll go through the installation process. I'll make sure that my server meets the minimum requirements. I'll click on Continue. I'll click on Upgrade Moodle Database Now. And once I see this message, I can click on Continue. And then we're done. Okay, now we need to head back to where your quiz is. So go to your quiz or your course where your quiz is. So I'm in my ICT skills course, and this is the quiz I'm going to use. So click on settings, then scroll down under question behavior, click on question behavior, and then you'll see shuffle within questions and then how questions behave. We'll use the immediate feedback option here. Click on show more, then you'll see allow redo within an attempt. This should be no, and then each attempt builds on the last. This will be yes. Scroll down to where you see extra restrictions on attempts. Make sure you hide questions on attempts. Hide the correct answer questions in the new attempt. Then this will become available, question auto grade. Make sure that you select auto grade the correct question. Scroll down. And now you can click on Save and Display. Now let's test the quiz as a student. Okay, so I'll switch my role to student. I'll click on the quiz. I'll attempt the quiz. Then I'll provide three correct answers. Let's just select that one, make that 8 million, and make that World Wide Web. Okay, I'll choose incorrect answers here. Let's just... Okay, so I've answered 7 questions out of the 100. I'll submit all and finish the attempt. I'll submit all, submit all. Okay, so I have 3 questions correct and the rest is incorrect. Okay, so there's my 3 questions there. Now I'll finish this review. Okay, so I want to reattempt this quiz. Okay, so I'll click on Reattempt Quiz. Now immediately you'll see the questions that I've already answered are hidden, okay? So the correct questions, the correct options I've provided are hidden. So it only shows me the incorrect options. So now I have a second chance to only focus on the questions that I've answered incorrectly. So now I can select, let's say, all of the above, whatever the answers are. Okay, use that, use that. Okay, so I'll submit all now again. Submit all, submit all. Okay, so there's one question I've answered correctly. So you'll see it in the review, but it won't show up when you reattempt the quiz again. Okay, so this plugin is really outstanding because when you retry, you don't want to see the questions that you've already submitted as correct. You don't want to see them again. Although they are graded and they are added to your grade, you only see the ones that you were struggling with. And this makes the learning process so focused. which is really valuable, a valuable feature that this plugin brings to the table. Okay, so again, there are my other questions, so I can only focus on those ones now. I've already covered, I know these other ones, so now I only focus on the ones that I'm struggling with. One other important aspect that you need to take note of, and I haven't mentioned this before, you need to make sure that if you click on grading, attempts allow should be more than one. Okay, so this feature won't work if there's only one attempt on a quiz. Okay, so you'll see immediately it changes. It will only work when there's unlimited attempts or more than one attempt. Okay, so then it will start hiding the correct responses of the students. So make sure that attempts allowed, this should be on unlimited or more than one attempt. It's also very important that you communicate these settings to your students so they understand the behavior of the quiz and the purpose behind hiding the questions on subsequent attempts. Now, what if you want to get rid of the settings? So if you find that you don't want to use the settings anymore in the quiz, you open the quiz, go to the settings, and then undo the changes that you've made. So first you'll click on question behavior. You can leave it on immediate feedback, and each attempt builds on the last. You can click on no. You can select no here. Okay. Then under extra restrictions, you just remove the settings. You just disable this feature. Okay. When you click on save display, it will return to its normal quiz setup. Okay, and the students can go through it one by one. Okay, so what if you decide one day that you want to get rid of the plugin once and for all? You don't like the plugin, you don't want to use it again. You go to site administration, you click on plugins, and then plugins overview. Once here, you click on, you search for the plugin that you've installed. So you can scroll down and remember it's under quiz rules, quiz access rules. You scroll down and you search, there's quiz reports, quiz access rules, and you'll see there's the plugin that we've installed. All you need to do is you can uninstall it from here. Click on continue. Here you need to confirm that you want to uninstall. Click on continue again. And then it will upgrade the Moodle database. You'll upgrade it. Click on continue for the last step. And that's it. So the plugin will be removed from the access rules. You'll see there's no more. So you'll see the plugin doesn't exist anymore. And that's it. So by using this powerful tool, you can help your students focus on what really matters, improve their quiz performance, and streamline your grading process. Remember, it's all about making learning more efficient and effective. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to give it a thumbs up, share it with your fellow educators, and subscribe to my channel for more Moodle tips and tricks. If you have any questions or want to share your experience with this plugin, drop a comment below. Thanks for watching and happy teaching.